A sin is a sin, brother. There's no variation. A sin is a sin.
Yeah,
but Jesus never sinned.
Where's the Quran?
No, you're going with assumption now.
You're contradicting your own faith.
Can I give you the answer?
See, what you're doing is showing that.
No, because you're going with assumption.
I'm going to give you the answer.
You're going with assumption.
I know more than what the Quran says.
No, I didn't say that.
What you did? Because you said that Jesus sinned, but what is your own Quran?
Everyone sinned.
It's clear. Okay, Jesus did sin.
Everyone.
Why did you contradict your own Quran?
Can I say something?
Your Quran says that Isa is sinless.
Exactly.
Isa is faultless.
Exactly.
And Isa is righteous.
There's no variation of sin, brother.
A sin is a sin, brother.
Is it your friend?
Is it the Quran or
a sin is a sin. A sin is a sin. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
So who's right? Muhammad?
A sin is a sin. You're not God.
You. Very simple question. Are you going to answer the question?
Go on.
Answer.
Bit silly what you just said.
No, I'm asking you a question.
You think to know more than
you said.
Dumb and silly.
Is sinful. All people are sinful.
You're saying in a nice way.
Therefore, Muhammad, when he got a revelation from Allah, was lying about sin.
Are you even a Muslim? Yes or no?
Yes.
So why would you say it doesn't matter earlier on? Why are you hiding your...
Because
he's debating you about the Quran. Duh. Use your brain.
I wasn't talking to this guy. Earlier, he came to talk to me. It doesn't matter, you're talking to him now.
So let's deal with this issue. You grant me to speak to me privately.
Surah
Maryam.
Speak to that woman there and the other lady there.
Okay.
Where's the love of Jesus for Sodom and Gomorrah and Moses was commanded to kill?
Sodom and Gomorrah.
The Sodom and Gomorrah.
The Quran condones Sodom and Gomorrah. So now you're condemning it.
No,
you're asking a question that doesn't make sense.
I didn't finish my question.
No, you said Sodom and Gomorrah. Where's the love in Sodom and Gomorrah?
Let me finish.
Your Quran condones.
No, I get what you're saying. Look, if I heard what I said.
You're not understanding.
Don't ask me a silly question.
So what you're doing is you've got double standards.
If it's silly, I would interrupt you.
You're telling me you're Christian, and he's Christian, and you believe Jesus is love, and you keep jumping in.
Whoa. You're talking about Sodom and Gomorrah. Now you're going somewhere else.
You don't understand about that.
Because what I'm trying to say to you is
he jumps up people. He's charging Allah now.
I'm going to put the Bible on Christianity as a standard.
But
then your own Quran affirms
and you're telling me Jesus is
exactly.
So that's why you're all over the place.
Exactly.
These are confused Muslims.
Exactly.
So anyway, are we going to look at this?
I'm asking a simple question. Why is he shouting first?
Are we going to look at Surah 19?
I was chanting these guys. I was chanting that lady in the balloon.
Surah 19.
And he went, I'm privately.
Do we see what Surah 19 says?
The angel said, I am only a messenger from your Lord to announce to you the gift of a righteous son.
So he's reading your Quran, man. Respect.
I don't know. Respect, man. He don't care about his Quran. You don't want to know about your Quran, do you?
Sir, are you scared?
You don't care about
Are you scared, sir?
Where's the love? Should
you read your Quran? You said that all people sin.
Free angels.
So are we going to go to your Quran? Says
he doesn't want it. He doesn't want to understand what the Quran says.
Of course,
I'm saying every prophet sin.
Okay, show us the sin of Jesus then.
The difference is all the prophets are forgiven the future sin, even if you think something.
Sir, you're saying something garbage.
What's the game?
Show us what Jesus said. Prove yourself. I am a Christian. Prove it.
You're following false.
Prove it then.
I am.
Okay, go on.
Where's the original Hebrew?
Where? is Jesus' sin?
Yes. He asked me to prove it.
Where is Jesus' sin?
Asking a question.
Go on. Where's the proof? Where's the proof?
Where's the original Hebrew?
You don't need to cover your face. Are you scared?
Why don't you film yourself as well?
Are you scared?
Film yourself.
I can't film myself.
You can turn the camera off.
Fuck is that?
I'm not going to film myself.
Why not?
Because when I want to, I will.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But you see, you don't want to turn the camera to you.
So you don't have the proof, yeah?
I don't want to be filmed. So you don't want to be filmed.
You don't want to be filmed. You'll be making a noise.
You don't want to be filmed either.
Cover. I never said I don't want to be filmed.
You don't want to film me.
This is Speaker's Corner.
You're not filming.
Everybody. Yes. Everybody. If you're here, you're going to be filmed.
I can say nicely. Don't you say safe.
You don't have a proof.
No, he's safe.
You can say it nice if you want. You can
I asked some other dudes.
I'm safe. I'm always on video.
No, no, you're cool. No, he's cool.
No, no, no.
Other people, you can film me.
Show us a proof where Jesus said.
Prove it.
Okay, alright. So, what's the question? What's the question?
Where Jesus said.
Yeah,
Jesus. Where Jesus actually said. He said Jesus is a sinner.
Okay. Yeah, so where is Jesus sinner?
Okay.
According to the Quran,
can I ask you? Yeah. Yeah. Is your name Godwin, yes? Yeah. 1 minute.
What's your name? What's your name?
John Doe. Yeah? So, I'm going to give you
so
one.
He was a joker.
That just sounds.
That sounds. John Doe. Is someone walking past you named John Doe? Imagine his name
Jane Doe.
Jane Doe.
A female.
Is that a real name?
Is that a real name? Everything.
That's why I'm laughing. Because I could tell you made it up. And this is the problem with Muslims. They lie and they make
things up.
So in the Quran, yeah, Allah says to Muhammad, yeah, that your future sins and your past sins are forgiven.
No, we're talking about Jesus.
All the prophets.
We're talking about Jesus. What? What? Did you hear him? No, he answered a question, but it's a silly answer. He said it applies to all the prophets.
What?
Are you doing your own tafsir?
But somehow, it applies to all the prophets.
He said, well, Jewish prophet.
You just said that you're on camera, brother.
Give a chance.
Yeah?
Your future and your past sins are forgiven.
And then that applies to all prophets.
But he still, wait, can I say?
You said that applies to all prophets.
How does that apply to sincerity? You say
John Doe. John Rambo, you're lying.
One minute, yeah. I asked to speak for 1 minute, I spoke for 20 seconds, you jumped in.
You asked me the question, and I responded.
Yeah, but I can
question.
Ask 10 questions, and you can come back and ask one question only, by my
no, we asked you
no, you didn't. You didn't answer it, sir.
You answered, okay. And now we responded.
John Rambo.
Don't try to play trick games.
Okay,
John Rambo.
I'm going to say this, let me say this thing. I'm going to speak for 1 minute, I may ask the question, but don't answer
all right,
the question.
1 minute, go on, 1 minute.
So we've asked you the question, are you going to respond to that question?
Yeah, I did already. Oh,
no, where did Jesus say?
Let me finish.
Okay, continue what you said.
Okay, no, Allah says in the Quran, Muhammad says to them, your sins, future and past are forgiven. But what I'm trying to say is, the point is this.
Wow.
So,
I haven't jumped in.
The Quran says, I'll repeat it. That Allah said to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, your future past sins are all forgiven.
Okay.
However, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is so beautiful in nature. He wants to show you how to repent. So every day he repented. More than us, 100 times a day he said astaghfirullah. Even though his wife came to him and reminded him, why do you say astaghfirullah? Why do you ask for forgiveness when Allah has forgiven you already your future? He said, am I not to be dutiful to my Lord and be grateful that I should not be pleased and happy for him, to him who created me?
You got 20 seconds.
20 seconds. Okay, so what we've asked you is, where
exactly.
That's
the question.
Exactly.
Yeah. We're talking about
Muhammad. We're talking about how Muhammad was asking
for forgiveness for sin. Come on,
so
bro. John Rambo.
Okay.
You're rambling about, man.
Let me read the verse that you're referring to. In Surah 97:96. So, not all Muhammad said, none has the right to worship Allah. And ask forgiveness for your sin and also for the sin of the believing man, believing woman. Well, you're moving about and you're praying the rest. So here, he's speaking about Muhammad.
That's the verse.
That's the verse.
That's what I said.
Okay, so
if you just sin forgiven and okay. Pass it. There's a verse later.
We asked you about Jesus, not Muhammad, to start with.
But the point is, my friend, we asked you about Isa.
We learn about Jesus.
We asked you about Isa.
Sorry, Imran.
We asked you about Isa, but you ran over to Muhammad. Now, the problem we have here is your Quran says that that Isa is righteous, sinless, faultless, okay, right? But in the Quran, it never calls Muhammad
righteous sinless forces, okay? So you have a righteous
no
God.
No need.
There's no need.
Who's good? Don't create your own tafsir. Your own tafsir. We don't need your own tafsir.
It's common sense. So the question is, who do you follow?
Exactly.
Do you follow the righteous man?
Uh-huh.
Or do you follow the sinful man?
Uh-huh.
Okay? And so,
uh-huh. No, you don't have an answer.
Listen. Okay. First of all, we know everything about Muhammad's life since then. We know from his birth to his 40 years of revelation to his death. We don't know everything about Jesus, first of all, from A, when he's there's a year period, don't
does
lie.
Do
not
Allah
lie.
Know? Does Allah
what's
know?
Your point? We don't know about Jesus.
Allah made a statement.
No, wait, talk to us.
Wow.
What's
righteous.
Your point?
1 minute, yeah,
Allah made a statement that
no, we want to know your point.
Hypocrites.
No, but you, we don't want to know your point.
But he's saying we don't know about Israel.
You know when you're trying to say something, they know.
What is your point?
What's your point?
So my point, if you let me finish, you wouldn't be saying it doesn't matter. You wouldn't be saying
what's your point?
My point is this. When you were a child, you'll go through hormonal change. When you're fat, there's no need to science have proven it. It's good, it's called it ADHD for some people.
Keep talking.
Wow, 20 seconds, you know what I mean?
Keep talking.
When I do this to him,
Hey, don't be victim mentality, please. Victim mentality.
Answer the question. Why can't you just let
you're
me
the one who's emotional.
Why are you narrating?
Why are you so emotional?
Why are you narrating? Why are you commenting?
He's calm.
Don't comment.
He's calm. Why
are you talking?
John Rambo. Answer the question, please. No, that's your name.
He went on a rampage.
John Rambo, John. Then you can go.
No, you can go. I'll say first.
No, we are in Speaker's Corner.
So, the
we're
question
filming.
That you want me to answer, you say no one can answer. The problem is, you're not going to get the answer because when we try to talk,
we're not gonna get
you
the answer.
I'm going to say one more time. One minute I'm asking for. What's that? Give me 1 minute. Yeah? So, when he's a child, you're a child. You go through hormonal changes when you're about 13, 14, 15.
Is
it's
it?
Called adolescent stages. Yeah?
Is it?
When you rebel.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I like your little comment. For a Christian, it's not going to be.
Uh-huh.
But anyway, you know, like, you go through. Like, Mom, I'm not going to do that for you now. You're going to be rebellious.
Why is he giving that garbage lecture?
To 18. There's a gap. There's a 12-year gap.
What does that got to do with sin?
I don't know.
Where did you go?
Nothing to do with sin.
He's talking about
Jesus.
He's talking about teenagers.
He's talking about baby Jesus.
It'd be little.
What was the original
question? Maybe stepping in some proof.
Maybe. Where's your proof, man?
But
where's your proof? We don't go with maybes here.
God forgave Jesus.
Yeah. No, you don't need a minute, man. We can't even give you a second.
Man.
We can't even give you a second.
Okay, so Jesus, the question we're asking is, what does the Quran say? According to the Quran, Surah 19, it says that Jesus was, or Isa, is righteous, is sinless.
Different
interpretation. According to the Quran, Surah 47 and also Surah 48, it says that Muhammad was a sinner. So we're asking him, what does the Quran actually say about it? Because the point we're making is that if you choose to follow the righteous man or the sinful man over the righteous man, okay, then what happens when both of their statements contradict each other?
Exactly.
You have to choose the one who's sinless because, of course, they did not lie. And so now he's going to adolescence and when he was young and teenagers.
What does that got to do with sin?
I'm saying, what does that got to do with sin? So the question again.
Typical Muslim.
Welcome to Islam.
John Rambo.
Welcome to the religion of
Muslim.
I don't know.
No answer.
So you have no answer.
No answer. No answer.
I answered him.
You're talking about adolescence. We're talking about sin. You're talking about adolescence. Use your brain, man.
Okay.
My Lord.
Well, you know it's ridiculous.
Is
ridiculous, man.
Where's the missing guy?
You know what? You're not forgetting.
You know, you get what I'm
this
saying.
Is a, this is a decent guy.
What's his point? What's his point?
He's trying to say that you don't know the exact details of Jesus' life from when he was born to when he was older and when he was
yes.
So he's saying if you don't know it fully, then how can you say that he did sin or he didn't do sin? How can you say that?
Remember,
if you
don't know, I'm going to do what you just said. Just so remember what
that's his point. That's
what was his question? Brother, we can deal with that easily. Go for it.
What was his question?
Our response to that was, we may not know, or he may not know, but who does know? According to you, Allah knows, right? Okay? So according to the Quran, which Allah apparently revealed to Muhammad, it says in Surah 19:19, that this man was faultless.
Exactly.
And then when you go into the hadith, it goes on further. It speaks about Maryam and Isa as faultless. So we know throughout his life he was sinless.
Yes.
And so we do, you do, well, according to Islam, Muslims, they will be able to affirm that he was sinless, regardless of whether they know every single detail of his life.
Yes.
And that's the point we're making to him.
Yes.
So all the adolescents...
Yeah. Do you get that? Do you get that?
Does that make sense?
Yeah. Okay. It makes sense to you, though. That's good.
Like you're arguing over...
He doesn't understand. I do understand.
You're both agreeing on the same point, but you're not really...
Not really.
It's linguistic. It's linguistic.
But yeah, I think
it's linguistic. No, you're not...
No, but we need a proof of what Jesus said in Islam.
Yes.
Don't give us his adolescence that doesn't exist.
You can't say he's sinless.
To us, anyway.
You have no proof.
So you just reject
it. What do you mean? It says it in the Quran.
I'm trying to prove this. I'm trying to say
I'm trying to say this,
all the prophets, the sin
your
that
Quran
do,
says you're sinless.
Then what prophets would do would be
Jesus
totally different perceptive.
But
like,
what I'm saying,
a sin to us,
this is the
like, take
problem.
This,
he would sin
say this apple, say this tree had apple and I stole it and it was someone's garden. We would nowadays wouldn't think that's stealing, that's not that much.
Okay,
but back then, a prophet, if they took that, they would feel so guilty.
Jesus is sinless, man.
They're nuts are different. So any prophet, if they did sin, we don't know if Jesus was sinless. But even if, look. He asked this question, what's your point? And I'm trying to give my point, he just keeps talking and talking. And his buddy is like commenting because he's the audio of the camera.
Okay.
Doesn't want to film himself, but likes to be the narrator.
Did you finish?
No. So what I'm trying to say is this.
So
you know what?
This
guy's right, but he's not.
Sinner or sinless? Sinner or sinless?
We don't know. You can't say Jesus is sinless.
So you reject your Quran?
Your Quran says it.
You reject your Quran.
Can I finish?
No, you can't finish.
You reject your
Quran.
I can finish and I will finish.
Your Quran says it.
Regardless of if sinning or not, God forgave them.
You reject
what are you talking about, man?
I have to go up.
God forgave.